Hello everyone, myself Mrs. Mayuri Kangale, Assistant Professor of Mathematics from the Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are going to see multiple integrals, triple integration, part 1. The learning outcome is, at the end of this session, the students will be able to solve the triple integrals. The concept of double integral of a function f of xy over a given region in xy plane can be extended further to define triple integral. Consider a function f of xyz defined over a finite region V of three-dimensional space. Let the region be subdivided into n subintervals delta V1, delta V2 up to delta Vn. Let the point P with the coordinates xr, yr, zr be a point in rth subinterval. If limit n tends to infinity, delta V tends to 0, summation r equal to 1 to n f of xr, yr, zr into delta Vr exists, then it is called as triple integral of f of xyz over the region V. Let us see the notations. The triple integral of f of xyz over the region V is denoted as triple integral over the region V f of xyz delta V. Therefore, triple integral over V f of xyz delta V is equals to limit of n tends to infinity, delta V tends to 0, summation r equal to 1 to n, f of xr, yr, zr into delta Vr. Now, let us see the uses of triple integral. Triple integrals can be used to find first volume just like the double integral and second mass when the volume of the region we are interested in has variable density. Here we can see the geometric interpretation of triple integral. Now let us see the evaluation of triple integral. There are some rules to evaluate a triple integral. Let us see it. First rule, the triple integral can be evaluated by successive single integrals. Rule number 2, the integration always proceeds from inside to outside. Rule number 3, the integration order may coincides with the order that the differentials, for example dx or dy, appear. So we can specify the integration order by a list of differentials. For example, triple integral over V f of xyz delta V is equals to integration from A to B, integration from C to D, integration from P to Q f of xyz dz dy dx, where A, B, C, D and P, Q are the constants. Then to evaluate this triple integral, we will follow the successive single integrals, and these integrals will proceed from inner integral to outer integral, that is from right to left. Now to decide the order of integration, we will see the differentials. Here the differentials are dz dy dx. So the first integration is with respect to z, then with respect to y, and then with respect to x. Here the triple integral can be evaluated by successive single integrals as shown. See here, from inner bracket to outer, where the integration with respect to z is performed first by treating x and y as constant, then with respect to y, treating x as constant, and finally with respect to x is performed. Now pause the video for a minute and solve this example. integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 3, x plus y dx dy. I hope you all have solved this example. Let us check the solution. Let the given integral be I equal to integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 3, x plus y dx dy. The first integration is with respect to x. So, we can write it as integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 3, x plus y dx into dy. Let us integrate with respect to x, treating y as constant. The integration of x is x square upon 2, y is treated as constant, so the integration of dx is x. So, we get the integral as integration from 0 to 1, x square upon 2 plus xy with the limits 0 to 3 into dy. Now, let us substitute the limits. X is replaced by the limits, so we can write it as integration from 0 to 1, 3 square upon 2 plus 3y minus the lower limit 0 minus 0 into dy. So, we get integration from 0 to 1, 9 upon 2 plus 3y into dy. Now, here we will integrate with respect to y. So, the integration is 9y upon 2 plus 3 into y square upon 2 with the limits 0 to 1. Now, here again we will substitute the limits. So, we get 9 upon 2 plus 3 upon 2 minus 0 minus 0. The denominator is same. So, the addition of numerator gives us 12 upon 2, that is 6. Therefore, the value of the integral is 6. Now, let us go for the examples. Evaluate the integral. Integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, integration from 1 to 2, x, y, z square, dx, dz, dy. Let I equals to integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, integration from 1 to 2, x, y, z square, dx, dz, dy. Let us decide the order of integration. Here, the differentials are arranged as dx, dz, dy. Therefore, the order of integration is first with respect to x, then with respect to z, and then with respect to y. So, we can rewrite the I as integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, integration from 1 to 2, x, y, z square, dx, dz, dy. Let us evaluate the integral. We will evaluate this integral from the innermost integral. The first integration is with respect to x. So, we will treat y and z as constant. Therefore, we can take y and z square outside the innermost integral. Therefore, we can write the given integral as integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, y z square, integration from 1 to 2, x dx, dz dy. The integration is with respect to x, and the integration of x is x square upon 2. Therefore, we can write the integral as integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, y z square into the bracket x square upon 2 with the limits 1 to 2 dz dy. Now, let us substitute the limits. Upper limit is 2, so 2 square minus the lower limit is 1, 1 square upon 2. We get the integral as integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, y z square, 2 square minus 1 square upon 2 dz dy. 2 square is 4 minus 1 is 3 upon 2, which is a constant which can be taken outside the both integrals. So, we can write it as 3 upon 2 integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, y z square dz dy. The inner integration is with respect to z. So, we will treat y as constant with respect to z, which can be taken outside the inner integral. So, we can write it equals to 3 upon 2 integration from 0 to 1, y integration from 0 to 2, z square dz into dy. The integration of z square is z cube upon 3. So we get 3 upon 2 integration from 0 to 1 y z cube upon 3 with the limits 0 to 2 into dy. Now let us substitute the limits. So we get 3 upon 2 integration from 0 to 1 y into the bracket, the upper limit is 2, so 2 cube minus lower limit 0 upon 3 into dy. 2 cube is 8, so we get here this bracket value as 8 upon 3. 8 upon 3 is a constant which can be taken outside the integral. So we get 3 upon 2 into 8 upon 3 into integration from 0 to 1 y dy. Here 3 get cancelled from numerator and denominator and 2 4s are 8. So we get it equal to 4 and the integration of y is y square upon 2 with the limits 0 to 1. So we get 4 y square upon 2 with the limit 0 to 1. Now substitute the limits, 4 into bracket 1 square minus 0 upon 2, which gives us 4 into 1 upon 2, 2 2s are 4. So we get the value of integral as 2. Therefore I equal to integration from 0 to 1, integration from 0 to 2, integration from 1 to 2 x y z square dx dz dy is equal to 2. Thank you.